She can fly. She also knows every story about Peter Pan ever told.
Talk about a fangirl.
Wendy Darling is a proper English lady who learns that growing up isn't so bad and may even be preferable compared to Peter's immaturity. Wendy's character arc is accented by the film's beautiful score. But who could have crafted such an artistic piece of music? Let's find out. Oliver Wallace was born in jolly old London, England on August 6th, 1887. He studied music in many different places, including under LaGorge of the Chicago School of Music, counterpart in harmony with Brescia in San Francisco, piano with Louis Diamond, Professor Cotton of London, and MacDonald Hope of Los Angeles. After relocating to Canada from England in 1904, Oliver moved to the jolly old United States, becoming a citizen in 1914. He is frequently cited as the first musician to use a pipe organ to accompany motion pictures, later becoming a house organist for the prestigious Granada Theater in San Francisco and then Sid Grauman's Rialto Theater in Los Angeles. Eric Larson wrote, "It was always a treat to hear Ollie Wallace, one of our musicians from a few years back, tell of his early days at the old movie theater organ, blasting out, spontaneously, mood music for the silent film flickering on the screen above him. If the picture needed chase music, Ollie provided it. If it needed a love theme, Ollie gave it the old Hearts and Flowers. If it needed the fury of a cowboy and Indian fight with gunfire, Ollie let him have it. Bang! Bang!" Through the whole silent movie, no frame or act got by without Ollie's musical support. Oliver moved to Hollywood in 1930 and worked for Universal and Columbia composing for several sound pictures. His pipe organ prowess can be heard in the Franz Waxman score of the 1935 horror classic
The Bride of Frankenstein.
In 1936, he joined the Disney Studios, where he composed for a number of shorts. His first was Mickey's Amateurs. Other notable shorts from this era were Boat Builders, Mickey's Trailer, Mickey's Surprise Party, Mr. Mouse Takes a Trip, and Clock Cleaners. Oliver's first animated feature film was some movie about elephants or something. It was called Dumbo, where he acted as the musical director. He contributed two songs, When I See an Elephant Fly and Pink Elephants on Parade, as well as composing the score.
Look out, they're walking around the bed, on their head, clippity-cloppity, parade. In braid, pink elephants on parade.
In 1942, this film won him his first and only Oscar, along with Frank Churchill, for Best Music, scoring of a musical picture. Throughout the war, Oliver continued composing for Disney shorts. Between 1937 and 1956, he scored 147 shorts for Disney. In his years with Disney, Oliver proudly estimated that he had written more than 30 miles of soundtrack. That's way too many to mention, but a comprehensive list will be in the description. His most famous contribution during this era was writing Donald's hit song, Der Führer's Face, for the short of the same name.
In the Führer says, he is the master race. Be heil, heil, right in the Führer's face. Not to love the Führer is a great disgrace. So be heil, heil, right in the Führer's face.
According to Disney Studio Records, the song was published before the film was released, and Spike Jones of the City Slickers thought the novelty tune might make a good B-side to the main song of his new record. However, when the record was released, it was Der Führer's Face that drove the sales of the record to over 1.5 million copies and helped establish Spike Jones and his City Slickers as a bona fide entertainment phenomenon. A New York radio personality played the song in his show and got so many requests that he offered a free copy of the song to anybody who pledged a $50 war bond. That promotion was so successful that in just 2 days, the song had earned $60,000 for Uncle Sam. And it just goes to show you kids, Nazis are, and always will, be bad, but great for business. Also during this time, and not Nazi-related, Wallace contributed to all of the animated features, including Ichabod and Mr. Toad, where he did the whistling for Ichabod riding into the haunted dell. When Disney decided to continue making animated features, Oliver was Walt's obvious choice to write the score. Oliver wasn't involved with writing the many songs in the movie, since the three Cinderella song composers were brought in from outside, and they didn't have a relationship with Oliver beforehand. He still used their music to create a wonderful score for the film with the help of Paul J. Smith.
Isn't it lovely? It was my mother's.
Yes, but it is old.
Well, maybe it is a little old-fashioned, but... Oh, I'll fix that.
How do you do that?
Wait a minute. There ought to be some good ideas in here.
Most of the melodies in Alice in Wonderland were written by Oliver and Sammy Fain. These songs include...
How do you do? Shake hands, shake hands, shake hands. How do you do? Shake hands, state your name of business. You are old Father William, the young man said, and your hair has become very white. And yet you incessantly stand on your head. Do you think at your age it is right? It's right. Do you think at your age it is right?
Oh, we'll roast the blighter's toes. We'll toast the bounder's nose. Just fetch that gate. We'll make it clear that monsters aren't welcome here.
Oh, me, oh, my.
A match?
Match?
Thank God. Without a single note, we'll smoke the monster out.
We'll smoke the monster out. No, no, oh, my poor house and furniture.
The End Birthday Song was written by the three Cinderella composers, and Twas Brilling was written by Gene DePaul and Don Ray, who wrote songs for Ichabod. By the time production began on Peter Pan, Oliver was solely in charge of the orchestral score for the film, mixing the work of the collaborating songwriters and orchestrators with incredible composition of his own. In many ways, Peter Pan shows Wallace at his best, taking the songs by Sammy Kahn and Sammy Fain and elevating them into a lush, romantic score. His orchestrations for You Can Fly, featuring my personal friend, Bing Crosby's backup singers, Judd Conlon Chorus and Mellow Men, are remarkable and perfectly capture the film's sense of hope, flight, and adventure.
You think of a wonderful thought.
Any happy little thoughts?
Uh-huh.
Like toys at Christmas, sleigh bells, snow?
Yep. Watch me now. Here I go. It's easier than pie.
He can fly!
He can fly!
He flew!
Perhaps his best work in the film, though, is the simplest. The three-note... No, not that. The motif representing Peter himself, first heard on the solo flute as the silhouette of Peter arrives on the roof of the Darling's house. It is the essence of the film distilled into three notes. Simple, dangerous, mysterious, and thrilling. After writing brilliant scores for Ben and Me and Casey at Bat, Oliver got to work on his last animated film. Some other movie about elephants or something? I don't know what his deal with was about elephants. Anyway, it was called Lady and the Tramp. Of all his animated scores, this is the animation score where Oliver Wallace was able to write the most original music, mostly utilizing his own themes instead of using other composers' song themes. He also had a lot of help from orchestrators Edward Plum and Sidney Fine.
Down, lady, down. Darling, darling, are you all right?
Of course I am. Why shouldn't I be?
Well, I just can't help worrying. After all, in your condition, alone here all day, walking that dog...
From here, Oliver moved on to live-action films, most notably...
The incredible adventures of Darby O'Gill and the lost kingdom of the little people.
Once you're here, there's no going back.
Here's entertainment to delight the entire family with Sean Connery and King Brian, the fun-lovingest leprechaun ever to rule the land of enchantment.
He not only wrote the score with help from orchestrator Clifford Vaughan, but also composed the Lawrence Edward Watkin penned popular song, Pretty Irish Girl, and The Wishing Song.
Oh, I wish I had time to sing you a song, but when I get started, I'd sing all night long.
In Toby Tyler or 10 Weeks with the Circus, 1959, he appeared as an actor, playing the conductor of a circus band. He also wrote some beautiful scores for The Incredible Journey and Old Yeller, which did not make me cry.
Guys, turn it loose! Alice, watch out! Turn it loose!
Starting with Seal Island in 1948, Wallace also specialized in musical accompaniments for Disney documentaries, including nearly all the films for the People and Places series and some of the True Life Adventures. The music of White Wilderness, 1958, was nominated for an Oscar in 1959. Very rare for a documentary film.
In this land of many mysteries, it's a strange fact that the largest legends seem to collect around the smallest creatures. One of these is a mousy little rodent called the lemming. Here's an actual living legend. For it's said of this tiny animal that it commits mass suicide by rushing into the sea in droves.
Oliver remained active in the studio in Los Angeles until shortly before his death in 1963 at the age of 76. And in 2008, he was posthumously honored with a Disney Legends Award. Oliver Wallace was an incredible composer, creating countless scores for Disney shorts and many animated movies, as well as documentary and live-action film. His beautiful work has accented and complemented so many different films. His longevity in the field really is a testament to his skill. Animator and Disney legend Frank Thomas once observed, "Ollie was a madman. Funny, eccentric, noisy, unexpected, and loved by everyone, including us."
Now, being one of our favorites, Daisy had to have a song. So we gave the assignment to one of our composers, Oliver Wallace.
Daisy. What rhymes with Daisy? Daisy, hazy, mazy, crazy, crazy. Crazy over Daisy. That's it. Crazy. I think that sounds like you, Donald. Crazy over Daisy. That's it. Let's see what it'll do. Try it. I don't think that's bad, Donald. I think you'll like that. We'll put it down. La-da-dee-da. Okay, Donald boy, let's play it once through, see how you like it.
And when I'm riding along the street, everybody that I meet says, "There goes the guy that's crazy over sweet Daisy May."
Thank you for watching this episode of Discographies. Click the thumbs up button below if you liked it, and if you want to be notified when the next episode comes out, consider subscribing. Comment below with characters you would like to see us cover. Further reading and references are linked in the description. We hope to see you in another Discographies.